Welcome back to Unreal Tips and Tricks. We'll be wrapping up our two-part look into creating high-quality glass effects by taking a look at the spiral blur material function. Before we look at adding a blurred or frosted effect, let's create a material instance that we can use to tweak various properties of the glass material. Right-click the tinted glass material we created in the last episode and choose Create Material Instance. Name the new instance MI_glass. With the table selected, drag the new material instance onto element 1 in the Details panel to assign it. Now we can open up the material instance to play with the values we exposed in the last Tips and Tricks episode. The first parameter is Edge Tint Color. Enable it using the checkbox and then feel free to tweak the color using the color wheel and sliders. You can also use the text entry fields below to enter RGBA or HSV values. Hit OK when you're happy. Next up, we have the top tint color parameter. This lets us do the same thing to the top and bottom parts of the glass. Again, feel free to play with the color values until you get something interesting. Below these parameters are the scalar parameters, including edge opacity, roughness, and top opacity. Playing with the roughness value will adjust how sharp or diffuse the glass's specular reflection is. Using top opacity allows us to make the glass more or less opaque. And of course, edge opacity works the same way for tinted edges. All right, now that we've spent some time tweaking the glass parameters, we're ready to add some frosting using the spiral blur material function. Reopen the parent material, M_glass. We'll be getting rid of the scene color node in order to make use of spiral blurring on the top and bottom of the glass. We'll be multiplying the top tint color parameter by a spiral blur function instead. Right-clicking in the material graph brings up our search box. In here, search for Spiral Blur Scene Texture and create the material function. Now we can delete the Scene Color node and connect the result output of our Spiral Blur node up to the B input of the multiply. We also need to take the Scene Color Clamp to Zero output and plug that into the Opacity input of our Material Result node. There are a lot of inputs on the Spiral Blur function, but we only really need to worry about the top input distance to get a good-looking frosted effect. Create a new scalar node by pressing 1 while left-clicking, and then wire it up to distance. Now right-click on the scalar and turn it into a parameter. We'll call this parameter spiral blur distance. That's all there is to it. We can save and compile our material now, and then reopen the glass material instance so we can tweak the blur effect. I like to unmaximize the material instance window and then press F11 to get a better look at the table in the viewport. Now we can enable the spiral blur distance parameter and tweak the value. You'll notice that you can still tweak the color and opacity parameters as well. Thanks for watching this two-part episode on creating high-quality tinted and frosted glass. We hope to see you next time for another Unreal Tips and Tricks.